some announcements for us.
Brooke Strauss is going to be having a fundraiser. It's Touchstone Crystal, which is jewelry, and Mary Kay products. I have two girls that are willing to go be here, and they will give a certain percentage to Brooke Strauss for their sales, both girls. It's going to be April the 22nd. It's going to be a drop-in between 1 to 4 p.m., so if you can't get there at 1, you can get there later on in the day. Both will be here to help you. It's going to benefit Brooke Strauss Lutheran Church Helping Hand, which means the emergency fund for funds for people in need. There's flyers up here. If anyone knows somewhere that they can put a flyer, please take some. And I have some more that we need. And we'll see everybody. Bring a friend or friends. Hopefully, it'll be successful as a fundraiser.
Cool. Thank you. And are you going to announce it or am I saying it? You can do it? All right.
I see some faces that were here for breakfast, but I see a lot that were not. And so we have, the bunny hop through, and there are some cakes and pieces of candy. And so please walk through Fellowship Hall and pick up as you would like. And enjoy. Happy Easter.
Thank you. With that, I would like to say thank you to all the people who helped with the various worship services this week, tearing down the sanctuary, setting up the sanctuary. It's all very much appreciated, and I give you thanks for all that you have done. You have an announcement?
So if you look in your bulletin under the announcements, you'll see there's an ad in there for the 4th annual Cornhole Tournament at St. Paul's Penryn, Saturday, May 20th at 4 p.m. If you want to come play cornhole, you can do that, but Living Streets of Love is also going to be hosting our first line dancing event the same day. We will be starting at 5 p.m. So you can come play some cornhole, drop into the event hall, and do some line dancing.
I can see that. Line dancing and cornhole.
Not the same.
That could be fun. We can start a new trend.
Why don't you do it first, Thomas?
The other announcement that I wanted to say is some of you are familiar with Water to Wine, which is Pastor Dan's version of Our God on Tap. If you would like to go to Water and Wine, it is this Thursday night. In Schaeferstown at the Franklin House. If you would like to go, please let me know after worship today. I need to let him know from becoming. I don't quite know all of the topics, but I think one of the topics is going to be do we hate the way that God hates? So that could be an interesting conversation to be a part of. So if you would like to be a part of that, please let me know after worship today. Sharon!
Hello.
Welcome. Happy Easter! Did we catch you taking a nap?
I wasn't up as early as you, so no.
Pardon me?
I can't use the excuse. I wasn't up as early as you, so.
Oh, I know, but you were here practicing early this morning. So with that, where have you seen God at work in humanity? Or where have you seen love exhibited in humanity? Or, okay.
If anybody follows like stuff I post on Facebook and Lititz, there is a very nice ice cream place. It's really good. They had to close their little box that they had that they took, you know, comments and stuff because of all the hate that they were getting in there. Mm-hmm. And a bunch of us went to have ice cream on Wednesday. And it was really good. We took them apart and flowers. And just to see the appreciation on the owner and the worker's face for the support and the love coming out. And it was just so nice to see. It was, you know, this connection of neighborliness and love.
Nice. And ice cream.
Yes, ice cream.
And ice cream.
So Lititz Jesus Love has a food pantry with St. Paul's Veteran, and it's open 2 days a week. And this past Wednesday, we gave out Easter meals to families in need, and we served 44 families, which, based off the numbers we get each week, is at least 100 people from ages 0 to 60 plus.
Awesome. You have one.
Yes, I have one. Awesome. This just sort of blew my mind, but I'll move very quickly. Many of you did know my second husband, Bill, and he had 8 great-grandchildren. So after he and us had our ceremony, I started sending ceramic Easter eggs to each of his great-grandchildren, like I sent to my kids. This week, now that I have to mail them, so it means I need a lot of small cardboard cartons. So the other 2 weeks ago, we were sitting, a bunch of us talking, and I just said very casually, I don't know if any of you have any small cartons, I would appreciate letting me know. Nobody said anything, so I thought, okay, I'll manage. On Monday morning, I was at home, actually eating breakfast, and my doorbell rings. And here, one of the women who was there is at my door with 3 boxes. Never said anything, just said, here, can you use these, and left. And I thought, she's one of the newest people at Luther Acres. And I said, welcome to Luther Acres. Reading the article on the front page of yesterday's paper about people doing the right thing, I was so impressed and moved that the whole situation was resolved by people just talking, just being there. And it took one person to stand up and say, we need to fix this.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I brought the article in case you missed it, and it's on the bulletin board in the hallway.
So you know sometimes we try something new and we have no idea how it's going to work out. Have any of you ever done that before?
Yeah.
And how have they all worked out?
Nope.
Pretty darn good, right? So this year we thought, well, maybe we'll, for Good Friday, we'll do something different. We'll do a Stations of the Cross, and we'll do it some guided meditation. You show up when you want. We had 25. give thanks for the gift of baptism. Holy God, holy and merciful, holy and mighty, you are the river of life. You are the everlasting wellspring. In mercy and might, you have freed us from death and raised us with Jesus, the firstborn of the dead. In baptismal waters, our old life is washed away, and in them we are born anew. Glory to you for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams. Honor to you for waters that wash us clean, quench our thirst, and nurture both crops and creatures. Praise to you for the life-giving water of baptism, the outpouring of the Spirit of the new creation.
Wash away our sins.
Alleluia.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
We pray together. O God,
you gave your only Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection you delivered us from the power of death.
Make us aside every day to sin,
that we may live with him forever in joy of resurrection. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You may be seated.
does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did both in Judea and Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Now you might ask, well, why are they so challenging? you sat on your grandparents' lap, or even your parents' lap, and you heard a story, and I only know this from my experience, I don't know about yours, but there was one particular book that my grandson always loved, and he goes, "Grandpa, can you go get that sleep book?" It was the book about evening prayers. Now, you might think, oh, well, that's no big deal. Grandchildren do that. Yes, but does yours call you from Virginia and says, "Grandpa, read the book to me over the phone"?
No.
So the point that I want to make here is, yes, this is a familiar story to us. And how do we make it come alive for us? Because here's what I believe, that until we truly engage our own selves in the stories, they have no meaning. They're just stories. They're just stories. So we have two women that go to the grave, that go to the tomb. Two people who were very fond of Jesus. Now, we also know from other accounts in the Gospels, and by the way, you do know that each Gospel has a different account of the resurrection story. So Matthew's is quite unique in that what happens while Mary Magdalene and the other Mary are headed to the tomb, there's this huge earthquake. And all of a sudden, the stone is rolled away. Well, they were worried about, how are we going to get this open? Because, you know, the soldiers were afraid that they would come and take this body. So they asked if they could seal it with super glue. They did it. They did. But these two women wanted to go in and see, but how are we going to get in? Now, that story alone just can be kind of like, I've never experienced an earthquake, but I know people who have. When there is an earthquake that happens, the world changes. You can't go back to the way things were. It's maybe a little like COVID. You experience something that is so changing and so shattering, you can never go back to what was. You can move on to what might be new or to what is new. And I think that's one of the things about this story that makes it very interesting, in that Matthew talks about all of this big clash that's happening. And then you have these two women that look into the tomb. They don't really see a whole lot, but they go about their lives. I imagine that if I was Mary, I would be a little skeptical about going to the tomb. You know, here is where they laid my best friend. The friend who taught me how to care about people. The person for whom I cared about very much. I'm afraid. I would be afraid. Would you? Let alone the earthquake. And then you get there and you see this image sitting on top of the stone, this huge stone. And the angel there says, "Do not be afraid." Sorry, I'm afraid. I'm afraid. I'm afraid of what I might see when I go in there. He's not there. Not there. He's risen, as he's already told us. You know that the resurrection story, the key to the resurrection story is something has to die. Something has to die so that new life can sprout out. For those of you who like to garden, anybody plant seeds in the soil? They're dead. And then you water them, and then there's sunshine, hopefully. And they sprout out into new life. That's what this resurrection story is about. What was no longer. there is obedience by the Marys. There is fear of they don't know what to expect. There is joy in learning that there is new life. There is obedience in going to tell others about this new life. So there's the story. But how does it fit into your story? How does it fit into your story as someone who follows the life and teachings of Jesus Christ? Where have you seen resurrection? What tomb have you looked in to find something that wasn't there, but then to discover that something new is there and gives you a new lease on life, gives you a new way, a new understanding to experience the world? I don't know about your experiences, but let me tell you about two that I had in the last 2 weeks. And some of you were there with me when this happened. There's this little Italian restaurant in Akron that some of us like to go to once a month. And there was a conversation about, well, let's figure out who we are. It's something that I've been trying for us to figure out. Who are we as this community of faith? And after a bit of a time, we all went into the tomb, AKA known as breaking up into two groups that don't like to be broken up into groups because they'd rather do it all together. You went into some place you didn't really like to be. You had no idea what to expect. You looked in there, didn't see anything. You said, why do we have to do this, Pastor Jim? Am I close? Mm-hmm. Am I close?
Yes.
And then what happens? You were all afraid, and then you got joy on your face. And you came up with a beautiful identity statement of who we are. I don't have it memorized yet, do you?
No.
Look at the front of your worship folder. This describes Bergstrasse Church, an imperfect, but welcoming, accepting community of love and compassion for our believers. So now, my friends, we are on the obedience side of that. How do we go and tell that to others? How do we tell others that we are an imperfect people, but we are welcoming and accepting? We show love and compassion to our neighbor. Isn't that the story of resurrection? Isn't that the story of new life for others? And then there's the other story, where I walk into a social service agency in Africa, and someone says, I think I know you. I tell them my name and they say, okay, so? But then I say, I'm from Bergstrasse Church. Oh, that church! The one that talks about love. The one that has the same vision as we do about sharing love for other people. I want to be a part of that. That wasn't me saying that. That was them saying that to me. I want to be a part of that. That's what God does for us. I want to be a part of that. I want to be a part of where I see good happening in the world. I want to be a part of where I see love and compassion for our neighbor without asking why or how, but just being and just doing. We are all Mary, either Mary Magdalene or the other 20 other Marys that are mentioned in the scripture. But we are all Mary, filled with fear. And then we go and we experience something that changes our lives. They met Jesus along the way. They met Jesus along the way. I'm sure you've heard me say this a few times. Have you seen Jesus today? Have you? Did you recognize that the person sitting next to you is Jesus? Did you notice the person at Wawa when you got coffee this morning? Did you see Jesus in them? Or what about when you had to go to the grocery store because you needed eggs for breakfast this morning? Or when you stopped stop for gas in your car. Or when you came through Africa and saw the homeless person sitting on the bench. My friends, the story of giving, the resurrection story, when it becomes your story, that you see how your life has been changed from what was to what can be, is when God's work comes alive. It's when God's work comes alive and it becomes your story. So one other little tidbit that I think is very amazing about this story. Every gospel writer who talks about this story says that it is the women who first notice Jesus. It is the women who go to the tomb. One gospel writer says, well, it's because they have to anoint the body. But Matthew says, they went in to see what was there because my loved one was there. This should not be old news to you. But women in ancient times were very disrespected. They had no voice. No voice at all. None. None. But yet, who are the people who see Jesus the most?
Women.
The women. Sorry, guys, we're not always with it. In our world today, do you know who I notice that notices who Jesus is the most? The people for whom society, including ourselves, push to the margins or push aside for whatever reason that may be. Oh, they're experiencing homelessness. Or they may be suffering from addiction of whatever kind. They may
begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things are made.
For us, for our salvation, he came down out of heaven.
By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was become incarnate from the Virgin Mary,
and was made man.
For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, according to the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Judge the living and the dead,
and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church.
We acknowledge
one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You call your church to witness to your salvation. We give thanks for all theologians, preachers, and teachers who proclaim your gospel. Equip all the baptized to share the joy of the resurrection in all we say and do. Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You bring abundant life throughout creation. The green blade rises, and all creation greets the resurrection dawn. Preserve vineyards and orchards, and those who tend to them. Feed us with the fruits of creation. Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You show your steadfast love without regard to borders, barriers, or human-made divisions. Infuse your justice in every nation of the world, that all experience the peace that only you can give. Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You anointed your Son with the Holy Spirit and with power. Encourage us by his examples in our ministries of healing, care, and outreach. We pray for all who are sick or hospitalized, especially Tessa, Jennifer, Ellen, our homebound members, persons affected by the Palmer chocolate explosion and by the Mississippi tornadoes. Grieving for Randy Fragel Jr. and Mary Medicus, and for all healthcare workers who care for them. Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You have put gladness in our hearts. Inspire musicians and dancers to rejoice with songs of victory. Bless the music ministries of this congregation and all who foster our assembly's song. Risen Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Generous God, in this meal, you offer your very self. We give thanks for these gifts of the earth. In the breaking of this bread, reveal to us the risen one. In the pouring of this wine, pour us out in service in the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Our God. It is right to give you thanks.
salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith as he comes to us in his Holy Supper.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." At this table, everyone is welcome. Everyone is seen. Everybody matters.
No one falls between.
At this table, you can say whatever. You can speak your mind, and everything is forgiven.
There is enough room for everyone.
So come as you are. Remember, the door is always open. The perfect gift that you can bring is your heart.
So come. Come as you are.
At this table, there will be no judgment. Mercy has a seat. We are all sons and daughters.
There is no place I'd rather be.
At this table, everyone is welcome. Everybody matters. Everybody cares, and everybody matters.
Come as you are.
Remember, the door is always open. Come as you are.
Perfect gift you can bring into your heart. Come. Come as you are. Pull up a chair.
Reveal yourself to us in the sharing of this meal. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Breathe new life into us. Send us forth burning with justice, peace, and love.
Come, Holy Spirit.
We praise you, O God, now and forever.
Amen.
United in spirit, we pray together as Jesus taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Come and know Christ, broken and poured out for you.
Thank you. blood of Christ shed for you.